Hi guys, welcome to the channel. So today we are going to start with the second case of electric field due to linear charge distribution. So this is basically the second case in which we will be having linear charge distribution spread vertically. So suppose positive charge is distributed vertically just like this over a length of capital L. Okay, this overall length is capital L, and at this point P, this point P could be aligned with the center of this rod also, or could be somewhere else also. So that's why I have shown this point slightly downwards, right? So now suppose this point P is at a distance of small x from this rod. Okay, now suppose this rod is having some angles theta 1 and theta 2. Suppose it is making an angle of theta 1 here and theta 2 here. Okay, these two angles, theta 1 and theta 2, from this end and from this end. Okay, now suppose this is a small length dl. This is a small length dl which is at a distance of small l from here. Okay, from here it is at a distance of small l, and it is making some angle with point P. And suppose that angle is d phi. And this is overall, this element is at an angle of phi from here, okay? With the horizontal line, it is making an angle of phi. And this dl length is having an angle of d phi with point P. Right? Now, if I extrapolate this line like this, okay? Then this small length dl, suppose this overall length is having overall charge of capital Q, and this small length dl is having small charge of dq, due to which it is having small field of dE. Okay, so at this length dl we are having charge of dq, and due to this small charge dq we are having some field at this point P that is equals to dE. Due to the small charge dq we have small field dE. Now because this overall angle is phi, so this overall angle will also be phi. Why? Because these are vertically opposite angles. Now in the direction of phi, with respect to phi, this particular element of E will be dE cos phi, right? With the angle of phi, it will be dE cos phi, and at 90 degree angle here, it will be dE sin phi. Right, so these are the two components of dE. Now, this dE cos phi is perpendicular to this one, right? This linear charge distribution, it is perpendicular, so it is also called E perpendicular. And this one is parallel to this charge distribution, so it is also called E parallel. Okay, now suppose this length, this particular length from here, from dl to P, this is small a. Now I hope all the lengths and all the angles are clear. and these components are also clear. Now we will move on to the derivation part. So now the small dE, this small field dE will be equal to what? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught charge. Charge will be dQ by distance square. Distance is A, so it will be A square. Now we know that lambda is linear charge distribution, right? So we can write down dQ is equals to lambda dL. This we have already studied, right? So here we will write down lambda dL instead of dQ. So we can write it down as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda dL by A square, right? This we have already studied. So instead of dQ, we are writing d lambda into dL. Now look at this particular triangle. I am making this triangle here. If you look at this triangle, this particular length is L from here to here, right? This part is X and this part is A, right? This angle is phi. Now here if you find out cos phi, it will be what? Base by hypotenuse. So it will be X by A, base by hypotenuse. So from here you can calculate the value of A square, right, which we want here. So from here A square will be equal to what? X square upon cos square phi. Now substitute this value of A square here, so you will get dE is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda dL by, instead of A square we will write down X square by cos square phi. Now you also know that we can write down cos square phi is equals to 1 by secant square phi, right? So instead of cos square phi, we can write it down like this. dE is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda dL by x square secant square phi, right? Because cos square is equals to 1 by secant square phi. Now what we are going to do is, again look at this triangle. From this triangle you can find out the value of tan phi. Tan phi will be equal to what? Perpendicular by base, that is L by X. So from here you can calculate L is equals to X into tan phi, right? So if you differentiate both sides, you will get dL is equals to X into secant square phi d phi, because differentiation of tan phi is secant square phi, right? Now this value of dL you can substitute here. Okay, this value of dL you will substitute here and you will get dE is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by X square secant square phi, and instead of dL we will write X secant square phi d phi, right? Instead of dL we are writing this from here. Now secant square phi will cancel out with this one, 1x will cancel out with 1x, and we will be left with dE is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by x d phi, right? We will be left with this part only. Now what we have to do is, we have to find out E perpendicular and E parallel. So now what we can do is, we know that E perpendicular is what? E perpendicular is integration of dE cos phi, right? So E perpendicular is integration of dE cos phi, and now we know the value of dE. We have to substitute this value of dE here. So we will be getting E perpendicular is equals to integration of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by X cos phi d phi. On integration we will get E perpendicular is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by x integration of cos phi d phi. So E perpendicular will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by x. Integration of cos is sine, so it will be sine phi. And limits will be from where? Limits will be from here. You will see, from this point we have to go from minus theta 2 to plus theta 1, right? From here we have to move from minus theta 2 to plus theta 1. So here limits will be from minus theta 2 to plus theta 1. So it will be like this. After opening, you will get E perpendicular equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by x sine theta 1 plus sine theta 2. Why plus? Because sine of minus theta is minus sine theta, and minus minus will be plus, right? So this particular formula you will be getting. This is E perpendicular. Similar way we can find for E parallel. Now E parallel will be equal to what? E parallel will be equal to integration of DE sine phi, right? Now substitute the value of DE. So it will be equal to integration of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by x sine phi d phi. So it will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught x integration of sine phi d phi. So it will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught x integration of sine phi is minus cos phi. Limits will be same, minus theta 2 to plus theta 1. So it will be upper limit minus lower limit. And here you have to remember cos of minus phi equals to cos phi, right? And sine of minus phi in previous case equals to minus of sine phi, right? These two things you have to remember. Star mark these. Sine of minus phi equals to minus sine phi, and cos of minus phi equals to cos phi. So here we will put the limits 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught x. Lambda is also there, no? Lambda. Upper limit minus lower limit. You will get cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. So this will be E parallel. Now we are going to discuss one special case. If suppose that rod or that wire which we are assuming is infinite, then what will be the value of E parallel and E perpendicular? So suppose we are having this wire like this, okay? We were having point P here, right? This was making some angles, right? This was angle theta 1, this was angle theta 2, right? And suppose this wire is going from minus infinity to plus infinity, right? This is an infinite wire. So what will happen if the wire is infinite? From here, if you look at the angle, from here the angle will go up and up and up and up. If the wire is infinite, it will reach up to 90 degrees, right? So theta 1 will reach 90 degrees. Similarly, this theta 2 angle, if the wire is going infinite, from here angle will be going up and up up till 90 degrees. So theta 2 will also be equal to 90 degrees, right? So for infinite wire, in case of infinite wire or infinite linear charge distribution, but remember this is case of vertical linear charge distribution, what happens? These two angle becomes equals to 90 degrees. So what we have to do, we have to substitute the values of theta 1 and theta 2 equals to 90 degree in each of these two formulas. So for E parallel, here it will be lambda by 4 pi epsilon naught x cos of 90 degree minus cos of 90 degree. Cos 90 is equals to 0. So this will be 0, this will be 0. 0 multiplied by something equals to 0. So E parallel equals to 0. Now we look for E perpendicular. So it will be equal to what? K lambda by, or you can say 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by x sine of theta 1, that is 90 degree, plus sine of theta 2, that is also 90 degrees. So it will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by x sine 90 degrees 1, 90 degrees 1, 1 plus 1, 2. So it will be 2 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by x. So this will be the value of E perpendicular in case of infinite wire. So this was the second case of linear charge distribution. In the next video, we will look for the electric field at any point around the circular charge distribution. So I hope this video was helpful for you. So far, that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching.